Starting in Le Pouilly-en-Velay, Stevenson walked southwards 156 miles, crossing the Ligne des Cévennes several times to reach Arles. After spending several days and nights in these mountains with no one but his stubborn donkey Modestine for company, Stevenson arrived in the village of Luc.
Robert Louis Stevenson would have come down here himself in 1878. He'd have come across this bridge into the village of Luc, having spent the previous night up there in the hills, sleeping rough in his sleeping bag in the rain.
Perhaps a little downcast by the weather, Stevenson was unimpressed by Luc. He wrote, "It had no beauty, nor was there any notable feature." He didn't stay long.
Here we are at the station at the Luc village on the Cévennes line, heading south to La Bastide de Puy-Laurent. And along this line itself, Stevenson would have walked in 1878, right by the railway, leading him to have some musings about the impact of the railway on local life. In fact, he was expressing possible concern that the arrival of the railway would bring so many people that this would no longer be the wild place that he loved. If anything, it was Stevenson's journey himself and the legacy that he left with his memoir that has brought people here to follow in his footsteps. A railway ran beside the river, the only bit of railway in Gévaudan, although there are many proposals afoot and surveys being made, and even, as they tell me, a station standing ready built in Mende. A year or two hence, and this may be another world. The desert is beleaguered.
Eventually published by Stevenson as Travels with a Donkey in the Cévennes in 1879, this walk is still a hiking trail that is followed by around 7,000 people per year.